Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. It's time to fix PUBG. That's the title of an article published by the developers where they talk about their plan to fix bugs, performance problems and quality of life issues during the next few months. Many players were quick to dismiss that plan by saying too little too late because PUBG is already dead. But you should not believe what some people say in their clickbait title videos, because while PUBG does indeed no longer reach that all-time peak of 3 million concurrent players, it still has more than 1 million concurrent players, which is a number that many very expensive AAA multiplayer games can only dream of, which is probably also the reason why we see some of them forcing a battle royale mode into their next release. So on fix.pubg.com, the developers provide a very nice list of things that they will work on during the next weeks and months, which includes changes to the server performance and the networking of the game. But what is the current state of the netcode after update 19, which has been released recently and featured a change that should have a dramatic impact on the server performance? Before update 19, every update sent by the server contained detailed information about everything that was inside the player's field of view, no matter how far away an enemy player, car or door was that he received an update on. Since update 19, the server now takes the distance between the player and these networked elements into account and then adjusts how frequently the player receives updates depending on how far away it is, which is very similar to how the high-frequency update areas work in Battlefield games. Now, before we dive deeper into the subject, I want to say that while I always do my best to keep the netcode analysis as simple as possible, you will still need to have some basic knowledge about computer networking, tick rates, update rates, network models, super bullets, lag compensation, packet loss, and a few other things like how I do my network delay tests. So, to keep the netcode analysis video as short as possible, I've put all this information into a separate netcode 101 video, which you should have watched at least once before you continue with this video here. The card overlay in the top right corner of this video, as well as the link in the description down below, will both take you directly to that video. So, if you've seen any of my previous netcode analysis videos for PUBG or Fortnite, then you know that it took Epic Games many months to rework and optimize the Unreal Engine, so that the server and the networking would not get crushed under the load created by 100 players. The Unreal Engine simply was never meant to support a first-person shooter with such a high player count, which is why the send rate or tick rate of the server dropped to an abysmal 8 Hz when the match began and then slowly increased as the player count dropped. 3 months ago, the reworks and optimizations done by Epic Games finally paid off, because since version 4.2, Fortnite is not only able to provide a stable 30 Hz throughout the match, also the network delays are quite decent now, no matter how many players are alive. These optimizations that Epic Games did were then also made available to all studios that use the Unreal Engine, as licensing the engine to other studios is their primary business. So, a few weeks later, PUBG increased the maximum send rate of the server to 60 Hz with update 14, but the player count still had a huge impact on the server's tick rate, which also caused an inconsistent player-to-player network delay. Now, after update 19, which can use different replication rates depending on the distance between the player and the networked item that the server wants to tell the player about, the server is now able to maintain a fairly stable send rate of 60 updates per second, no matter how many players are alive. You only see a drop in the send rate during the time where many players are still inside the aircraft, but as soon as you are on the ground and found a gun, you usually receive 60 updates per second from the server. Now, what does this mean for the network delay that two players are affected by when they play on the same server at a ping of 25 milliseconds each? Since version 4.2, Fortnite servers are able to provide quite good delays at a stable server send rate of 30 Hz, no matter how many players are alive. In update 14, the PUBG server would reach a maximum send rate of 60 Hz when there were less than 40 players alive. However, the network delays were still significantly higher than what you got in Fortnite. And when there were more than 85 players alive, then this resulted in a server send rate of about 20 Hz and terrible network delays. Now, after update 19, the PUBG server is able to maintain a fairly stable send rate of 60 Hz, and that results in much better network delays, especially during the first few minutes. The damage and gunfire delays are also lower than what I measured with update 14. However, the movement delay got a bit worse and is much longer than what you get in Fortnite. So the replication rate changes in update 19 did significantly improve the overall server performance, as you can see here. However, Fortnite shows that you can get those delays down even further, So this is what I want to see from that Fix PUBG initiative. Now, how does this change affect the network traffic generated by PUBG? With update 19, the average downstream traffic got lower, most likely thanks to the replication service now taking the distance between the player and the networked items into account and lowering the rate when something is very far away. The upstream traffic, however, is slightly higher now, as the client now sends 120 updates per second on average instead of about 97 updates on average. Compared to Fortnite, PUBG does need a lot more bandwidth, but that should not be an issue for most players considering that even the maximum upload rate is below 200 kilobits per second. So with update 19, the network delays did not only get lower, they are also no longer affected by the amount of players who are still alive, which is a massive improvement. However, this does not, and quite frankly cannot, fix the issue where a player who has a ping of just 25 milliseconds to the server receives damage far behind cover when he gets shot by a player who has a very high ping. This is what many players refer to as desync, and they think that this is a bug that needs to be fixed. However, what is happening here is that the game's hit registration simply does not care about the negative impact that registering the shot has on the experience of the player who has a decent ping to the server. So, while the long movement delay does slightly affect this as well, there is no bug to fix here. That said, especially in a battle royale game, we cannot have players who suffer from a high ping cause a bad experience for players who did nothing wrong. This is then where many players will usually demand a region lock. However, that is pointless, because even when you live in the same country as where the server is hosted, you can still suffer from massive ping spikes that go past 300 milliseconds. The most common cause of this is buffer bloat, and if you want to know more about that, then you can find a link to a video in the description down below, where I explain what that is and how you can prevent it. So, what you actually want is that the game's hit registration uses a sane limit for how much delay it will compensate, which effectively puts a cap on how far behind cover a player with a decent ping to the server can be hit. DICE implemented such a feature in Battlefield 1, which I explained in great detail in my Netcode 101 video, to which you can find a link in the description down below. So, there are four things that I would like to add to the Fix PUBG roadmap. Number 1. Have the game show warning icons to tell the player when there is either something wrong with the performance of the server, his ping, latency variation, or when he has a lot of packet loss. Because many times the reason why you have a bad experience in the game is because of a networking issue between you and the server. So it is important that the game tells you when there is an issue, so that you can then further investigate the problem by, in example, enabling the network graph like Battlefield or CSGO provide. Which is the second thing that I want the developers to add. It must at least show the server's tickrate, the player's ping to the server, latency variation and packet loss, as well as the client's send rate. And it would not hurt to have it show the IP of the server, as that will help the developers to track down the data center where that server is located. Number 3. Show me the ping of the player who killed me. Because when I know that I have a ping of 10 milliseconds to the server, and my killer had a ping of 20 milliseconds to the server, then I know something went wrong when I died 10 meters behind cover. With this information on screen in a gameplay capture, it gets a whole lot easier for the developers to actually track down and fix these issues. And number 4. The developers must find a way to prevent that players who have a really bad ping to the server cause a bad experience for players who have a good ping to the server. And the region lock is not the solution here, as I explained earlier, as players who live in the same country as where the server is hosted can still have a ping of more than 200 milliseconds to the server, either because they suffer from buffer bloat, or because they use mobile internet, or because their ISP simply has a problem. There are many different reasons for ping spikes and high latency variation that a region lock simply won't fix. And that's all for today. I will keep you updated on the progress that the developers make with their Fix PUBG initiative, and if you like the work that I do here on my channel, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would simply not exist anymore. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts, in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time when I test the netcode of the Black Ops 4 beta. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.